Hello everyone, you are watching Dorukhan. Today we are in the Tribal Tuesday and we are going to try a whole new tribal deck. We are in the Servants of the Emperor and Adeptus Mechanicus. Ed-Mech is our feature for today. They are really quite strong in the tabletop right now and it's quite fascinating to play them. However, their Warlord is actually among the weakest warlords available for the Servants of the Emperor, where you have Kenneth Viridian, Inquisitor Grefex and Commissar Yerik. It's a challenge to be strong on your own, but Magos Dominus Ivasnofon actually underperforms really bad. For his plus 20 wounds on a unit that doesn't really keep up with the rest special rules, combining with using Ed-Mech units instead of those who synergize well with him will be even more challenging. In fact, this is the third game I am recording and I have lost the first to a Bedrock, second to a Tao Shadow Sun deck, both really strong mono range decks where we have lost, and let's see if we can take at least one victory with this deck and gain our honor back. I have invested 230 gold for this deck. I used I believe this deck in 2 months ago in the Adeptus Mechanicus Ed-Mech campaign keyword mission. For then, before the death blow was a thing, I kinda made this deck worked. So let's see if it will be work this time. I don't have much of a hope for the ranked matchmaking has no mercy, for it shouldn't have. We are basically in here to win, and this deck is a simply fun deck to play. We are against Voldus. Perhaps we can play around Voldus. So once again, in order to increase some morale, I made this decision in the previous decks and videos, and simply I am going to provide you with some background music. I hope the music doesn't get copyrighted. This is the Warhammer 40,000 Mechanicus video game original soundtrack, Children of the Omnissiah. I will also provide a link down below. I believe this Warhammer 40,000 Mechanicus video game has a really lovely soundtrack, and I advise you to play that one, give it a try. Let's go ahead and take out that card for the first, but yeah, they have a taunt yet, so they will simply ignore us. They are to go with psychic in my opinion, so taunt is going to take that damage, so why don't we simply put our unit in there. They are to go psychic, most likely. Our Rust Stalker should tank the damage and simply fall. Alright, the damage reduction I think is taken down with that, but they have select melee for some reason. Most likely they have a higher melee attack. Yeah, they still in 5% damage reduction, so they are reducing ones in there. But Doomcrawler will take that one down. Unfortunately, the Librarian will get his psychic attack increased, which is quite sad. But we will hit him for some high damage with our two Tech Priests. Quite a lovely composition. I really enjoy using a deck like this. I believe 5%. So annoying. It's just survive, it's just too not cool. This deck is really killing me, guys. Like I was around 1800 trophies when I started recording this Ed-Mech episode. Combining with the today's disaster with the Cynic Road episode, it's quite annoying. Uff. Really uff. Okay, EC over 40, of course, is not just with 39, so our big game hunter is a joke in this case. With 53 combined with the psionic blast, it will most likely be good enough to take us down. Let me match my dune crawler over there, and let us actually poison the unit on the far left. Tech priest is to full, and I think I am going to transit. We are not doing good, not good at all. Our ranged has been debuffed thanks to this lovely apothecary. Their deck is actually quite synergistic when you think about it. Alright. They have select psychic for as it's expected. Our tech priest has fallen. Using him on there, it won't really make much sense. So I'm going to put my Warglaive on here. Our Sylphurhound should take them down. We have enough ranged attack. And perhaps we can actually poison the unit bodyguard, the last bodyguard of the Voldus next round. I mean, in a Adeptus Mechanicus deck with a, I expect this deck to perform much better, but of now they are going hit with 63. With 50, I should have expected Tigris to be next on the line. I believe our attack reduces to 49, but this time I am going to deploy an outflank unit to increase my attack back. And this time with the increased attack, I think we should take down Apothecary as well, and Tigris will be the only bodyguard that will be left alive. Our opponent will hit less than 63, so our Dunecrawler should be safe. However, Voldus's special rule is in there, so I don't know if this 20% increase to him be good enough or not. Alright, he has been matched with the Warglaive. He's less than 40, so our attack is actually Big Game Hunter won't work against him. At least Voldus's psychic attack isn't good enough to take us down, I was going to say, but it actually is. And also Voldus has a ranged attack as well, courtesy of the Grey Knights. They have all the attack types. Doesn't matter, we were going to die to him anyway. Alright, Warglaive survives with the 5 HP, and I believe this is game. But it was really stressful, and considering that we actually lost two games prior to this, and only winning at a third game and in a 1616 trophies, doesn't really satisfy me. So I hope you had some kind of perspective on how AdMech tribal would be in Warhammer Combat Cards. Yes, at least we have received back a really good trophies back, 70s of them, half of what I have lost. That's some compensation reward, perhaps. Volus, I believe, in my opinion, is a Space Marine Warlord that is easy to take down when you are matched against. Captain Ekran takes just too long time, but you get there eventually. Logan Grimnar, perhaps sometimes it can be problematic, but regardless, you can draw him quite early. Tomron is hard to mediocre depending on the situation. Who is left? Artemis can be hard, can be quite hard sometimes. And 230 gold just to lose 70. I hope the kill pack gives something nice, so because I really need some motivation right now. I love the Warhammer 4000 Mechanicus video game. I really love the AdMech lore. Alright, 9 plasma and 79 gold, that's good enough. We have made back our 80 gold of our 230 investment. Yes, Corbodash and the Wallbreaker. I use Corbodash, the other is quite squishy and I don't use. Siblis is a good chaos taunter. This Inspiring Presence chaos units, I have ignored them for over 3 months, but I might actually start using them in a few of my chaos decks, not in my Skulltaker deck, but in others they may be featured. The other two I don't use. Bottom two. Alright, 2 pages of commons. The newest chaos scout unit, I have considered using this in my Skulltaker deck due to its low cost, but the scout is only one time attack and it's really situational. It's mono melee, it's synergistic with the Skulltaker, but I have my doubts. So far I haven't used him. If you have any success with this card, please mention comments down below. Yes, Scourge, I love this card. It's great in using my in my Zephyr Blade, in my Free of the Craft world, even in Rakard and also in Lelith as well, and I think it makes a cut in all of the 4 Eldari Warlords. 4 out of 5, for it's not a psychic and not good with Eldrad, which I don't use. Alright, only 2 rares in a kill pack, quite sad. This lovely gentleman will be featured in the Astra Militarum Imperial Guard episode in Thursday. I also am a fan of Imperial Guard, they are quite cool. And our 2 rares. 1 Ethereal unit from Tau, I don't use. It has melee attack only for some reason. And Shadow of the Caliban, the Dark Angel's mission reward card, of the best used with Tolmaron, which I also don't use. So this kill pack that has been rewarded to us by the contribution of the Edmech Warlord Ivasnophon is quite lackluster, just as himself. If you are a fan of the Edmech and him in this game, I hope you did not get offended. Regardless, you see how he performs. It's not satisfactory at all and quite sad to see such a lovely faction to underperform. I hope this episode has been some eye-opener for you. We tried to make this work, however, as you might expect, not everything has to work all the time in the way you construct them to be or want them to be. Another life lesson in this Tribal Tuesday episode. Until the next time, where we are going to feature the Tribal Imperial Guard, Tribal Astra Militarum in Tribal Thursday, I would like you to take good care of yourselves.